Hi, I'm Mary Poplin with Boris FX, and today I'm going to show you how to remove a tattoo using silhouette paint. I am using After Effects as my host for the silhouette paint plugin, but everything that I cover in this video can be also done with the silhouette paint inside of Premiere, Nuke, Flame, Resolve, and Fusion. To get started in Silhouette, we'll go to Effect, Boris FX Silhouette, and Silhouette Paint, or you can always search for it in the Effects and Presets menu. This applies Silhouette Paint as a plugin under our effects controls. From here, I select Open, and the Silhouette Paint plugin launches and asks me to create a new project. We're going to create a project called Tattoo Remove, and hit Create Project. Now, if I look at this shot, let's go ahead and hit play, you can see that the tattoo is moving in perspective. That means painting this would be kind of a pain. So what we want to do is we want to paint this using a track. That means we need to go to our Roto tab inside of Silhouette. We will select an X-spline from our tool menu and zoom in. All I need to do to create an X-spline inside of Silhouette Paint is click for points, and they're automatically joined. I can then adjust the shape however I like. Because I want to track this, I'm going to click the Tracker tool. Inside of the Tracker tool, we have several different options. One of them is a point tracker, one of them is Silhouette's planar tracker, and by default, we usually select Mocha's planar tracker. Because we're all tools under the Boris FX umbrella, we all share technology. I'm going to turn off auto on minimum percent of pixels used, and I'm going to preview what Mocha is looking at. Now that looks like a good enough texture to me, so I'm not going to adjust the sharpness or contrast. We're going to click track forwards. From here, everything we do in Silhouette will be based off this track, as long as we tell Silhouette to base our tools off this track. Once the track is complete, I can correct my roto shape by using the reshape tool, or R if you're using hotkeys, and I can make sure that our tattoo is always contained inside of this shape. And that looks pretty good to me. I'm going to add a blur of 5 pixels to the shape because that will give me a little bit of edge softness when I'm blending this paint back in. Now we can go to the Paint tab. Inside of the Paint tab, I'm going to zoom in on this bear. We're going to go to our viewer and we're going to stabilize based on our tracked layer. This is going to freeze our frame right in the middle of our viewer based on our track. So what's cool about this is because Silhouette is a raster-based paint program, I can paint on this as if I were painting in a Photoshop file. I'm going to select my paint tool and we're going to actually just paint straight color first. And because we are using a track to drive our paint, we have to select our paint track before we start painting. So we're going to select our layer that we tracked for the bear tattoo. And we can show those shapes if we need to. Showing shapes is actually pretty handy when you're painting because you can see what your boundaries are when you're painting. If I want to select a color or change the brush size, I can right-click to select a color or click and drag to select an average. And to change the brush size, I can hit Control to make my brush bigger or smaller by clicking and dragging. I can also change the opacity of my brush strokes. Now, we're going to fill in some color really quickly. And I'm just painting on the normal, which is the color and detail together, and our R, G, and B layers combined. I'm going to keep right-click and average selecting these colors on her shoulder until I get some coverage for this tattoo. Now, the reason I'm doing that is because when you are painting tattoos, there's a lot of dark details, usually on lighter skin. Getting rid of those dark details on lighter skin can be kind of tedious if you're not paying attention to what the colors are. So what we're going to do is we're going to paint the colors first, and then we're going to blend this all together. Some people like to use the smudge tool for this, but it really depends on personal preference. And like most paintings, it's going to look a little bit disastrous until it doesn't. You can also use the open and close brackets to make your brush size larger and smaller. I'm going to take my softness all the way up, and I'm going to fill in some soft colors for her shoulder. I'm going to take our opacity down, and we're going to start laying this in like an actual painting. Because when you actually paint, you want to paint with a little bit of transparency. Now, I'm not going to worry about too much accuracy right now, because what we're going to do is we're going to blend all this in using the blemish tool. The blemish tool is a blur and a grain combined. And before I can apply it to my shot, I actually have to make sure that my opacity is turned all the way back up to 100. Otherwise, when I go to compare my grain to match the grain between the blemish tool and my shot, I won't be matching it at the proper opacity. Now, I'm going to bring this all the way over to my arm area so that I can match the grain this way. Now, I can see that's actually pretty close, but let's compare by channels. If I click on the red channel, I can start to match the grain this way. And this feels a little bit like it needs to be a little bit sharper, so we're going to go down to our softness, and we're going to take our softness down to 1. We're going to do the same thing for our green channel. We're going to check it. It looks pretty good on the green channel. That actually looks pretty correct to me. Let's check blue. I'm going to take the softness down on blue as well. And so now that we have something that kind of matches our grain or matches our grain good enough, we're going to turn our compare mode off and we're going to go back to our RGB channels combined. And you can see that this blends really nicely. All right, but that still doesn't look like skin. So how do we handle making it look like skin? Well, what we can do is we can actually sample the skin texture alone and put that over our color data. We do that by selecting the detail. What detail does is, and I'll just show you right here, color is just the color in the image, and detail is the texture in the image. This is a little bit similar to the high pass filter in Photoshop. So let's go to our output, and let's select clone. And we're going to clone from our skin texture into our blemish tooled area. We're going to use shift and click and drag. And what that will do is that will select our offset for us. But we're also going to set our source to the output instead of the foreground. That means instead of sampling the original image, we're sampling what we paint. This is going to be important because I need to cover up this texture that was the tattoo. And I don't want to introduce tattoo texture back into my paint. So let's go ahead and just paint the skin texture right back in. And you can see that that makes just a huge difference right away. And we can make sure we're pulling from the right sections for the highlights, for example. And then we can continue to use this to fill in the texture across her shoulder, just like that. And very quickly, we have painted out this tattoo. Now, I want Silhouette to auto-paint this for me, so I'm going to select my paint instance, and you can see that this is all of my brush strokes, and I'm going to select Match Move, and then I'm going to hit Play backwards. And Silhouette is going to fill in every paint stroke based on my track and the brush strokes that I put down. So instead of me having to paint every frame, Silhouette's going to repaint every frame based on the data that I gave it. Now, I've sped this up because it actually does take a minute to write every single one of these frames. Think of it as rendering. Once this is done, we're going to have paint strokes on every single frame. Once the auto paint is complete, I can go to my viewer and set it to none. And let's zoom out. And let's not show my shape anymore. And we'll hit play. We can hit Save Project, and close. And now inside of the Silhouette plugin, we have applied our paint. And if I want to use my shape to contain my paint, I can select Painted Alpha. I could then composite this paint onto my shot, but I like how it looks with the source alpha. And when we hit play, Silhouette renders right back to my timeline. And because they're raster-based images that have already been rendered, it renders really fast. If you have any questions about how to use Silhouette, please see our website at www.borisfx.com, where you can find case studies, user stories, tutorials, and so much more.